Hey VC, it's ZoneKTechKid here. New video update. Lots of records. I'm not gonna show everything, just gonna show some of the records, and actually I'm just try to show you things that I've heard, because I have lots of stuff that I didn't hear yet. So it's better, because this way I can give you my opinion and I can recommend something or not. First of all, I want to let you know that our record, Dabaptism EP, it's almost sold out in the market. It's limited to 300 copies. It's almost sold out. I just received an email from our distributor. There are like 25 or 30 copies left, so I managed to order 7 copies from him. Just for the vinyl community. In my previous video I mentioned that maybe it's a good idea to upload the records in Dabaptism Bandcamp page, but I don't think this is a good idea, because there is some demand for those records and I really want to keep them for some guys, because some guys show interest to buy our EP. In that case, we can do it together. I mean, we can do it via PayPal. Normally the record is cost 9 to 10 euros in the record shops, but if you give me 7 euros plus shipping, I will personally ship our EP to you. If you're interested to buy our EP, I will include a link so you can preview the tracks. Tudor received my record. Glad that he liked it. It's good music, dub techno, good music quality. We put quite a lot of effort on this EP, and now we're preparing the second one. Anyway, if you want to order it, I only have 7 copies, just for the vinyl community. So let me know. First of all, I'm gonna show you this, which was a grail of mine. Just received it today in the mailbox. Bossa Nova, the boss of the Bossa Nova, name of the release, out on Atlantic, Joao Gilberto, the stereo copy, original copy. Bossa Nova, if you don't know, Joao Gilberto is one of the main and the first Bossa Nova artist, along with Joao Carlos Jobim. This thing is fantastic. It was a grail of mine. It's not easy to find records like this in Europe, so I order it on Discogs. If you like Bossa Nova and you want, you know, this smooth Brazilian flavor with vocals and the warm voice of Joao Gilberto, this is highly recommended. At least for my taste of Bossa Nova, I really enjoyed it. A nice compilation, which I posted yesterday on the Facebook vinyl community page. Super Breaks, Essential Funk, Soul Jazz, Samples and Breakbeats. This is double LP, amazing compilation of samples, lots of good stuff. On this one, I found it in a record shop while digging and picked it up. I couldn't resist and I didn't regret it. Highly recommended the compilations. If you're a fan of compilations and samples, there are a lot of them here. You can check the track list. I highly recommend this. Yeah. As I told in my last video, Jill Scott Heron records are starting to become a little bit hard to collect, even the reissues, and they are getting more and more expensive, so I took the opportunity to grab this one, Free Will by Jill Scott Heron. This is Gatefold, amazing artist. The first side of this is a little bit, you know, singing and more melodic and easy listening, let's say easy listening Jill Scott Heron stuff. The second part is spoken with percussion, and the second part of this one was my favorite part of this album, out on Flying Dutchman label. This is the reissue. I also ordered his first LP, which is maybe one of my favorite ones. I also really like the last one of Jill Scott Heron with out on Excel Records a couple of years ago. If you don't have any records of Jill Scott Heron, do yourself a favor and grab a couple of them. Two soundtracks. I'm starting to collecting soundtracks now. Of course, I have some in my collection, but something is wrong with me with soundtracks, and I want to get even more. This is a limited edition pressing of Sin City, A Dame to Kill For, the latest sequel of Sin City, the movie, which is very good. Nice music, nice packaging, pressed on a red record. The music was very good. Okay, it's not Blade Runner by Vangelis, but it's something highly recommended. It's limited, and I'm a big fan of the movie, so Sin City, Frank Miller's. One more, this time by Death Waltz, Room 237. This is early electronic synthesizer stuff, as you can see also in the picture. This was a good listen. I'm not sure if it's the best Death Waltz release, but this thing was like €9, including shipping, on the German Amazon, which lately gives me a lot of good offers, and I can't resist buying them. The packaging on this thing is amazing. I'm not gonna show it, I'm not gonna open it, because it's very thick and it's a little bit pain in the ass to do. It includes two posters, one inner lyrics thing, a CD, and pressed on orange red vinyl. Good soundtrack, good electronic music, early synthesizer music. If you like Vangelis Blade Runner, for example, this is something that Joe Carpenter and stuff like that. Check this out. Not the best soundtrack of all time, but it's quite good. Good listen. Yeah, this is a record that a friend of mine recommend. Actually, this was one of his favorite soul and R&B records. Laura Lee, A Woman's Love Rights. This record has sampled to death from a lot of artists. Apollo Brown, if you know him, Beatmaker, he's having a new release, which is very good, on my wishlist to sample this record. It was an okay listen. Yeah, I really like this record, but it's my friend of mine favorite soul LP. I'm not gonna agree with that, but I'm very happy to have it in my collection and really enjoy this from Laura Lee, out on Hot Wax. Lots of flea market finds, cheap finds. This is like €2, but for €2 it's an amazing record. Look at the lineup: Neil Jackson, Cannonball Underlay, Aldo Blakey, Hora Silver, Oscar Peterson, Plenty Soul, out on Atlantic. This is Gatefold. Not the best album, jazz album of all time, but Neil Jackson, I really like his vibraharp, you know, metallophone and stuff like that, so this was a very good listen for me. By the way, I also have some Blue Notes in the other room in my collection to show you, but I don't want to show you records that I didn't listen to them yet, because I think it's better if I can share an opinion on them. Flea market find, €2, but I couldn't resist. Aretha Franklin, best hits of greatest hits of Aretha. I think this is a native pressing, but I really don't care. Aretha Franklin, you should have some Aretha Franklin in your collection. I believe I also have a Greatest Hits LP by her, but it was very cheap. I grabbed them, I listened to her, and yeah. Don't need to speak a lot about Aretha Franklin. Ah, one more flea market find, very cheap. Greatest Hits of Mary Wells, Motown Records. I have the original copy of Motown on this on My Guy. Mary Wells sings My Guy, yeah, I think that was the title. But that was back in Greece, so you know, I can't resist leaving behind cheap finds like that because it's music I like. And also, I picked up this one, €1 find, but I really don't care. Fats Domino. The reason I picked that is first because this music reminds of my father. Fats Domino was one of my father's favorite artists, and I also like the record. I mean the packaging, you know, the flair of the 60s on those things. Musically, you know, Fats Domino, blues rock and roll artist. Talking about blues, I'm starting to be more open in things like that. And one artist that I'm really discovering those days is Joey Tex. I've got to do a little better. Flea market find out on Atlantic. Lots of Atlantic records lately. Don't know why. This was a very good listen. I can highly recommend it if you are into blues stuff. Joey Tex, give me some blues recommendations, actually. This is a new thing for me, you know, grabbing randomly artists from here and there in the genre. Joey Tex, I really enjoyed him so far. He's also having a new release, a new 7-inch, actually, called Pneumonia, I think, yeah, was an answer to the song Fever. And it were quite similar, something like a remake of the song Fever. Joey Tex continuing with a very good compilation, double LP, The Man, the Isaac Hayes, out on Stax. As I told you, double LP. You can't really go wrong with Isaac Hayes. I didn't have the Shaft soundtrack, which I think not included here. Ah, oh yeah. It's here, the Shaft soundtrack, sorry. I didn't have it, so I think it was a very nice idea to have a double LP by Isaac Hayes, and I really enjoyed listening on it the other day. One more flea market find. This is disco, but it was an offer, yeah, €1 for a record that costs 10-50 euros, I think. Oliver Zipman, Get Down Saturday Night, a hit. In the collection, why not? And finally, last record of the band, an LP by The Broken Bells. This is a pop, indie pop, synth pop record released on 2013, yeah, the end of the year, I think, so it's almost like 1 year old. Pretty good album by The Broken Bells. First Sight was my favorite. We played The Broken Bells in the radio station that I was working back in Greece a lot. The packaging on this thing was excellent, and yeah, that's a good reason to buy a record, I think. If you're not familiar with Broken Bells and you like synth pop, dreamy pop music, give them a try, because they are one of the best bands of the last years. As I told you, I have a lot of more records to show you, but maybe I need some more time to listen to those stuff. End of the month, I'm going back to Greece for some days, so probably the next video will be from Greece, showing you some records from my collection there. And thank you for watching. Let me know if you're interested to buy this thing. 7 euros plus shipping is the best thing that I can do. I grabbed 7 copies, so if you really want this thing, because some people asked me to buy this record, please contact me as soon as possible. There are only 7 copies, sorry about this, but this thing was limited. Maybe the next time we will press some more records. I will discuss all those things with our distributor. Anyway, cheers from Berlin, DC. Nice to see you once again, and take care, and always listen to good music on vinyl. Cheers.